Hi, and welcome to the first of a few videos I'm going to make on arrays, which are a really important concept in programming and not the easiest, so they take a few videos to cover thoroughly. Let's start by just talking about what an array is, so forgive me because it's going to be a slight wall of facts here. First of all, an array is an example of a data structure. For GCSE, there are only two data structures you've got to know about. You've got to know about arrays, and you've also got to know about records. But there are loads in computer science, and A-level computer science covers maybe six or seven different ones. A data structure is where we have multiple items being held under one identifier. So like a variable, they've got a name we give it, that's what an identifier is. But unlike a variable, we've got multiple items, not just one. Why are these a thing? Well, if I'm storing multiple numbers, I could go something like num1 is equal to 10, num2 is equal to 11, num3 is equal to 15, and so on. That's how I'd be using variables, but that is not a very efficient way of doing it. I've got to think up a new identifier for every single value, and really they're the same category of values. It's much more sensible to use something like an array where I can just go something like num is equal to 10, 11, 15, and that saves us a bit of space. But if I had 1,000 items or 1,000,000 items, that makes quite a big difference. We don't want to think up brand new names for every single value. Now for some more facts. So items in an array are formally called elements. So I often just call them items in all honesty, but they're meant to be called elements. Don't get thrown if you come across that word. An important fact to understand is that arrays are what we call static data structures. It's hard to imagine, based on that definition at the top, how we could have six or seven different data structures, but they all store data in different ways. All have got different features, all have got different properties. One of the properties of an array is they are static. Now, them being static means they've got a fixed length. The length can't change once it is first set. I'm going to look at this in the context of declaration in a second. I've underlined length to double emphasize this because arrays aren't fixed. They can change. They're not constants. You are able to change items or elements inside the array, but the length is fixed once it is created, which is important. Another important fact is that arrays only hold elements of one data type, only integers or only strings. You wouldn't ever have one element being a string and the next element being an integer. That just doesn't work with arrays. Now, maybe 95% of you watching will have learned Python. In Python, there are no arrays at all. So in Python, they are called lists. A list is another data structure, which is very, very similar to an array. So if you've learned lists, that's very, very similar to arrays. But the lists aren't static. Lists can change in length. It's why we have things like dot append in Python. And lists are also more flexible. They can have multiple different data types. So arrays are a little bit stricter. Arrays are what you're going to come across in paper two, although lists work in a very, very similar way. One thing we don't have to do with lists, however, is declare them. So arrays should be declared at the start. This is how it's done in OCR exam reference language. So we write the word array as a keyword to tell the computer that we are about to declare an array. Then you write down your identifier. This is the name you are choosing to be used for your array. So I'm calling this array cities. Then you do square brackets, and in the square brackets, you write down a number. And this number is how big the array is. So because arrays have got a fixed length, we need to tell it what that length is. And we're saying here, I'm only ever going to have four elements in this array. I can have fewer, but I can't have more. We've looked already at indexes in the context of strings. An index is a number used to reference a location of something. In this particular case, it is a location of an element in the array. So indexes are used to add elements to the array, potentially. So I can go something like cities, index 0. We write square brackets, we put an index number, we're saying we're indexing this using 0. Cities index 0 is equal to London. This is setting the string London to be held at location 0 in my cities array. I can also add Manchester at index 1. I've now got two items, two elements, I should say, in my array, London and Manchester. So if I was to print cities at this point, we would see something like this on screen. The first two positions have got our elements we've added, but indexes 2 and 3 are currently empty because I've not put an element at that position, which is okay. The purpose of my declaration is to basically allocate memory for four elements. I don't necessarily have to fill up all of the space, but typically we would put in elements for every position in my array. And if I print it now, we get a complete array outputted. can see that square brackets are enclosing our elements. We use square brackets for indexing and for arrays. But if I tried to add in another city, no offense to Nottingham, but this wouldn't work because I've only declared space for four elements. Adding a fifth element, Nottingham, gives us an index error. So despite this being put in at index four, I actually haven't got an index four because we start indexing at zero. The first item always says index zero and it counts upwards like this. So the four in our declaration is how many items we have. It's not our maximum index. Our maximum index is actually three because we start counting at zero, which is a bit confusing, which I totally understand. Now, this process of me adding four elements one by one is a little bit tedious. So you are allowed to sort of combine this into one step by declaring arrays with elements there already. So we can do something like this where I'm declaring an array called colors, which has three elements, and I'm just putting them in straight away in one line. So I just suggest you do this in the exam, but you might see what I just showed you represented as well. And if I wanted to print out one of these individual elements, I would just use index numbers. So let's say I wanted to print out the traffic light is currently red. Well, to access red, red is at index zero, amber's index one, green is index two. So I can print colors index zero, and I'm concatenating this with a string to print out the traffic light is currently red. Now we are perfectly able to reassign elements within arrays, as in change a value from one thing to another, because arrays are fixed length. They're not fixed in terms of their contents. The contents can change, it's just we cannot go beyond our initial length. If I've said colors has got three elements in it, I can't then just add in a fourth element, I'd get an error. That's where lists are different to arrays. So in Python you could do that, but in arrays you can't do that. But what we can do, like in Python, is within the array itself, I'm perfectly able just to change one of my values. So if I wanted to change amber to yellow, maybe people don't know what amber means, I can reassign colors index one, which is the index number of where amber is, to be now yellow. So that's overwriting amber with yellow. So now if I print the light is now colors index one, this will print out yellow, not amber, because yellow replaced amber when I reassigned it.